Today's house hunting mission is to help a couple to purchase their very first home together, if the figures stack up.
I would never have thought we could afford something as lovely as that.
We have properties where chores are valued.
Washing up takes on a whole new meaning in here.
And of course, there's the money shot.
That view is priceless.
Hello and welcome to Escape to the Country. Today we are in the beautiful Wye Valley, which is a unique landscape which covers more than 100 square miles and spans three counties, Gloucestershire, Herefordshire and Monmouthshire. It consists of beautiful woodland, stunning limestone gorges and of course the river itself. And over the centuries it has inspired some of our greatest writers, poets and painters. And I have to say, it's pretty inspiring for house hunters too. The protected countryside of the Wye Valley runs through the English counties of Gloucestershire and Herefordshire, as well as Monmouthshire in Wales, which is largely where we'll focus our house hunt. Prices for detached homes in Monmouthshire are currently around £24,000 above the national figure, but the county offers far better value than neighbouring Gloucestershire. Those looking for a lively events calendar can head to the county town of Monmouth, which hosts one of Europe's largest free music festivals. Ross-on-Wye is a good spot for lovers of art and crafts. You can browse and buy locally made pieces in the historic Market House building. But it's the great outdoors that's the real draw to this region. Whether that's walking in the magnificent Forest of Dean, braving the whitewater rapids on a canoeing adventure, or simply enjoying the idyllic valley scenery of the River Wye itself. With stunning views like this, it's easy to understand why so many people are attracted to this area. And the woodland here is considered some of the most beautiful in the UK, with most of its 4,300 hectares declared an area of outstanding natural beauty. And for today's house buyers, Ruth and Marguerite, this valley is going to be the doorway into a new, adventurous and outdoorsy life.
I'd like to just open my doors and see green space.
You know, I look at our potential garden as essentially another room in our house. The dream is to have in a space where our friends can come to visit and camp out. We can make the most of the summer times and just really make the most of being outside, full stop.
We've been together almost 4 years. And
we knew each other about 3 years before that, maybe?
Yeah.
I used to live my life in a slightly shambolic way till I met Marguerite. She was saying to me the other day, tell me what it was like when you used to go out in the morning, like go to work, and I'd be running around the house shouting, where's my keys? Just going absolutely bonkers, no cup of tea or anything.
I quite like things to be organised because I find it a little calming, and I like to avoid stress where I can. You know, it might sound sad, but before we go to bed at night, I put the tea bags in the cup and fill the kettle. So in the morning, it is like a military operation, kettle boiled, upstairs, showered, quick change, down the stairs. And it just means that her life is definitely a lot more relaxed.
It's amazing. My life is so much more relaxed since I've met Marguerite.
Ruth and Marguerite both have jobs in the education sector near their rented home in Easton, just outside Bristol city centre. Although they love their working life, they can't wait to swap their rented city home to buy a place in the countryside.
Owning our own house is something that we've talked about and dreamt about for a long time, actually, you know, and how we would imagine our house to be and our cowboy bath outside and all of these lovely things. And I think we've kind of both got to a stage where we think, well, what are we waiting for? We're both kind of ready for a simpler life, a slower paced life. I suppose the Wye Valley, because we've done a lot of camping and walking in the Wye Valley actually, and it is absolutely stunning in terms of the countryside and the views. There are definitely aspects of Bristol that we'll both miss, I would say, but the idea of taking this next step and changing our lives and our lifestyle is actually really exciting, and I think we're both ready for it.
One big thing the couple will miss are friends, most of whom they met through their local sports scene.
They Livingston Cowgirls are a community football team.
It's how you and I met, and it is the core of our friendship group here in Bristol.
Yeah, they're an amazing, amazing group of people.
They're really, really excited about moving. I'm really excited for them, even though I'll miss them loads. I'm excited for them to find their new place and start a new life together.
Our whole club will miss them terribly because they're both very active within the club. But they're not going that far away. You know, it's really easy to get over to the Wye Valley, and it'll be lovely to go and visit them and get to enjoy the countryside with them. So I'm sure we won't stop seeing them.
Moving house to the country together is just going to be amazing. I can't wait to have our own home,
yeah.
Be able to potter in the garden.
Yeah, make our house into the home that we want.
Yeah. At the moment, we drive out to find the peaceful things in life and the things that make us feel really whole and really good about ourselves. And, you know, we want to live in that life rather than drive out to it.
Yeah.
What a lovely couple. And although I can see that there's a lot on offer in Bristol for Ruth and Marguerite, none of it can compete with their urge to quit the city and put down some rural roots. And with green, as far as the eye can see, I think the Wye Valley is going to be a breath of fresh air for them. All we have to do is find them the perfect house.
For a budget of £300,000, Ruth and Marguerite have quite simple property requirements, needing a minimum of 2 bedrooms plus a large reception to host visitors. The house should sit within a garden big enough for friends to camp in, with room for a hot tub too. And they're open to living anywhere in the Wye Valley, so long as it's within an hour's commute to their jobs back in Bristol. I'll be showing them around 3 very different and very lovely options, each with a different take on their wish list. But before I reveal the attached price tags, they will both have a stab at guessing the price first. Our final property is the Mystery House, which could leave us all with a welcome sense of déjà vu. And we've all arrived in the region, eager to get this property hunt underway.
Beautiful countryside.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah, the Wye Valley is stunning.
So it's the countryside that's sort of leading this move?
Absolutely, like the idea of being really close to lots of green space and just nature and being able to get out and into it without having to get in the car to do so is kind of... And just kind of the quieter life too, Ruthie.
Like yeah, we've both chilled out a lot.
Yeah.
You used to be a bit quite wild.
Yeah, a little bit.
Wow. Really? Wild party girls.
Yeah.
And what about the property itself? Is the outside space more important than the inside space?
I think my heart's kind of set on the garden. I haven't really given as much thought to what the inside of the house looks like.
Is that more your domain, Ruth?
I do want a really nice garden, but I'm very interested in the inside of the house, how that's going to look.
Yeah.
It's like I've got very definite ideas of what I like and what I don't like.
All right. And do you go along with those very definite
ideas?
I
don't really have much of a choice, Alistair.
You're going to be a home of two domains, garden versus inside.
Yeah.
En route to our first house tour, we're making a pit stop at the lower reaches of the waterway to soak up a little of the landscape they're hoping to find on their doorstep.
And this is the River Wye, and this is the valley, of course. And this side is England, that side's Wales.
Yeah.
Do you have strong preferences either way?
Oh, we're not too fussed, you know? No. Not too fussed at all. The fact that they're really close.
Anywhere beautiful would do us.
Yeah, well, this is pretty sure. Beautiful. Both sides are beautiful. Everywhere you look is beauty around here.
Yeah. And that suits us. Like, we would love to be able to access walks really easily without having to get in the car to do so.
Our search begins just over the river in Clandogo, a small village on the Welsh side of the Wye. Located on an A road following the river path means transport links and amenities are good for a village of this size. The pub has been serving locals and travellers for 3 centuries and continues to offer meals and accommodation. There's also a village shop. Plus, there's an excellent choice of footpaths available to explore this area of outstanding natural beauty. Located below a single-track road is the house we've come to see.
I'll wait till you clap your eyes on this.
What a view. Wow. That is the Wye, then.
You wanted the Wye Valley.
That's amazing. That is something else.
If I can drag your eyes back to the actual house.
This is incredible.
The house looks stunning. I would never have thought we could afford something as lovely as that.
Yeah, true.
Well, shall we have a look inside?
Yes,
it's pretty. Good. It's pretty. There's no wasted space here.
Okay, that's good. Ruth will be happy.
My favourite.
Thought to date from the 1800s, the original two-up, two-down stone cottage has been extended to the rear. The main entrance opens into the first reception room.
Come on in.
Thank you.
Straight through the front door into the dining room. The present owners have completely gutted and rebuilt it from the bottom up. Everything is being really kind of renovated with a great deal
of love. Well thought out.
It's nice also, it's like separate. You know, it's just its own little enclosed room.
It's got its own walls.
One of the houses we looked at, it was all open down below.
You don't like open plan?
Well, I do, but Marguerite was like...
I did like it.
Oh, hello.
Handbags.
Well, let's look at the kitchen.
Yeah, let's do it.
Come in. So, it's all a bit snug.
Yes.
But you want it snug, huh?
Cozy, yeah.
So this is all an addition. The original cottage wall is there. And just the one bathroom. So there's no bathroom upstairs.
No bath.
We really have a bath.
We hardly ever go in it.
It's just the idea of maybe having one.
No, and it's there if you want it.
But I think we've always said that we'd be really open-minded and we don't have any kind of real set expectations of the house as such, you know.
Well, what do you think of the kitchen?
I really like the fact that it has plenty of light. It makes it kind of look more spacious. You know, there's plenty of surface to work on. I think they've made a really good use of the space.
Well, should we go and look at the living room?
Yeah, let's have a look.
Lovely original doors. And then this is the super snug sitting room.
That's really sweet.
Love the fireplace.
Yeah, the fireplace is incredible and a log burner, which is really important to both of us.
We love a fire.
I grew up in a house where a fire was lit 365 days a year. Yeah, yeah. It's beautiful.
Low ceilings, even for me.
Yeah?
Yeah, there is as well.
It's kind of cosy though.
And look what you see when you look out. Again, that is unreal.
It's all about the view, isn't it?
Yeah, it really is.
And the views continue upstairs. Let's have a look.
This cosy cottage is capturing the couple's heart so far, so let's see what they make of the two bedrooms on offer. The guest room is a pretty double, with more of those captivating valley views, whilst a slightly larger double might suit as their room.
This one has this killer view.
I love the view from every single window. It's just amazing.
It's something else. Well, I always say that I think a small bedroom is really comforting and quite cosy.
Good job.
Yeah, exactly. That would work here.
Also stops you collecting rubbish. We both hate clutter, so...
It's perfect.
We could live in a house this bigger.
Definitely, we definitely could.
So let's step outside, look at your very important garden.
Yeah, sounds like a good idea.
We can also talk about the finances.
The interior has certainly passed muster. Now onto the third of an acre garden.
Let's go up top.
Okay.
Ruth and Marguerite want to have friends for overnight camping. Here, the current owners have put in considerable effort terracing the inclined plot to provide different levels to take in that incredible panorama.
Well, here we are. It's a beautiful garden. They've actually done a lot of work to kind of terrace it. It was all just wilderness when they moved in. Got an organic orchard here, some really lovely specimen trees. And really nice planting, very simple wild planting.
Which would make it really easy for us because we love the idea of gardening, but actually don't know much about it.
Here we go. This is what everyone says.
But this is ideal because it's more about maintenance, which is easier to do than planning a garden.
Well, they've done all the back-breaking work.
Yeah, absolutely. And it's ready to go. Love the fruit trees. That's something that you've always talked about, Ruth, is wanting a little wild garden.
Yeah, the butterfly garden.
Yeah,
yeah, absolutely.
And the views are just incredible.
So everything is thumbs up, it's all wonderful, but what is the price?
I'm just going to go for it. $290.
See, I was thinking $280.
Right. Okay, so you ladies are in for a shock. This property is a little bit over your top budget. It's on at £330,000.
Okay.
And I know that's over your budget, but you are chain free.
That is true.
So you could
go
in there.
And the other thing is there'd be very little to do.
Nothing, yeah.
Which makes a huge difference.
Oh, it breaks my heart though, because I really wish it was on at 290. But it's a beautiful property and we couldn't not show it to you.
Like, that view is priceless. You would be hard pushed to find a house where you could come out your front door and look over something like this.
So see if your heart is moved as you move around, and then I'll come and collect you when you're done.
Great,
okay,
thank you.
This stone cottage may stretch their finances, but it does appear to offer everything they asked for. Two double bedrooms, both feature those exceptional views, the garden covers a third of an acre, and it's less than an hour's commute to Bristol.
We could have our hammock in there.
We could have a barbecue area over there and listen to the birds. Look at that view. That is something else.
Amazing.
My first thoughts were, it just looked absolutely beautiful, like a tiny cottage, which is the sort of thing we're looking for. I love the cosy rooms. I love the fireplace.
The garden is so beautiful, and that view just catches your eye straight away, no matter what angle you're standing on. I've never seen a property as beautiful, you know, with the garden and with the views.
You know, I think we could live happily in this house.
Surely one of the top five views out of your front door that I've ever seen. Amazing. Hello.
Hello there.
I'm just mesmerised by your view.
I know.
It's unreal, isn't it?
It is something else.
It is, but I'm afraid I'm going to have to tear you away because we've got more houses to see.
Oh, okay, good stuff.
Keen outdoor adventurers Ruth and Marguerite love nothing more than a good campfire, so I've brought the ladies to the Wye Valley Sculpture Garden to meet bushcraft expert Stephen England. He's going to teach us how to safely harness our fire starting techniques in the natural environment.
So we're coming into the fire pit now. A lovely spot. So what I'm going to do is effectively set up a little bit of a test for you. A little bit about fire safety to begin with. There's some tongs which you can use to, if you need to move a piece of wood, if it's just moved a bit, make sure that we're not disturbing any wildlife or any plants or anything. We're working in a clear area so that the fire won't spread. Quick test, what do we need to make a fire? Three things.
Oxygen.
Air.
Fuel.
Oxygen.
I've got a bit
fuel.
Of an advantage here because I was a science teacher.
First thing.
And
fire. Spark. Ignition.
Yes.
Yeah. Ignition. So we're going to have a little trial run. That's for you. That's for you. Okay. We're going to have a go at getting just getting the tinder alight now. So if you'd like to take your respective positions.
Go this way.
Looks like I'm taking on Ruth to see who's the fastest spark here.
Hey, Ruth, do not let the side down here.
For ignition, we're using a piece of carbon steel, which gives off hot sparks when struck by a sharp edge, such as a flint. For fuel, it's cotton wool. But if you're planning a campfire, do make sure you have the landowner's permission first and that no fire bans are in place. Ensure the area is clear of grass, leaves, and trip hazards, and keep fires at least 10 metres away from tents and sleeping areas.
I'm feeling a bit sorry for you over there, Alistair.
Why?
I don't know.
Don't feel sorry for me.
Go down.
Just be afraid.
On go. Ready? Hang on. When I say go. Go. Okay. Ready, steady, go.
Go on, Ruth.
Oh, yes.
It's going!
Yay!
Hang on, I really think this should be best of three.
Just calm, take your time. Hey!
Yay!
Once the fire starts, the trick is to patiently add kindling to build up a decent heat and avoid smothering the flames.
The other thing is, what does a yellow flame tell us?
It's not so hot.
Yeah, it's just basically, it's not. It looks like you've got a fire going, but all you've really got is you're burning off carbon. It's just soot. so there's no real heat to it. So although you might get a nice yellow flame, it could go out very quickly. We've got the pros over here now. You see, yeah. they're pulling away. They're pulling away. You've won the competition, I'd say.
Woo-hoo.
Yay. Yeah. Well done. Yeah.
Thank you, Alistair. It's all about the taking part that counts.
Yeah, no, it's about the winning, isn't it?
I may have lost the battle, but we all get to enjoy the spoils. Drop scones al fresco.
Food cooked outside is always good, though, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. It tastes better.
Always tastes amazing.
Looks pretty good.
Nice. Okay.
To extinguish any campfires properly, it's always a good idea to have a bucket of earth, sand or water to hand.
It's actually really good.
With bellies now full, we must get back to the burning issue of Ruth and Marguerite's house search here in the beautiful Wye Valley. Our next house is on the English side of the River Wye in the Gloucestershire village of Rusbridge. 1.5 miles away is the small town of Cinderford, once the heart of the mining industry in the Forest of Dean. Here it's possible to catch a movie at the recently restored theatre or enjoy a meal in a choice of pubs and restaurants, including some of the most highly rated curries in the area. A short drive or bus ride away is the village of Rusbridge, where a quiet side road takes us to the house we're here to view.
A very different offering here.
Yeah.
This is the house. What do you think?
First impressions, a lovely house, yeah.
It's kind of a similar house, but a size up, isn't it? It's a very beautiful house.
Yeah. These would have been miners' cottages, two in fact, they've been joined together. This offers a lot in terms of space inside and in the garden as well, so let's have a look inside.
Yeah, fantastic.
Next to the house is a detached garage and driveway, whilst a central doorway takes us into two reception spaces that run from the front to the back of the property.
Come on in.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice.
Yeah, I love the beams.
Yeah, I like the open plan. You know, dining room, front room in together.
Yeah. And doors bring a lot of light into these rooms, which is fantastic.
So straight into, I mean, this could be anything. This could all be one big reception room.
Yeah.
And then you come down here, and here's your log burner.
Oh, fantastic.
Cozy.
Yeah. I love the fact that there's a chair either side.
Chair on either side. Yes, perfect.
I like it. It's cosy. I think I feel a bit spoilt by the first house.
House
was just so amazingly.
Let's face it, it's much bigger. And this is like probably double the floor space.
Yeah,
that's true.
Take a look at the kitchen, for example. Very spacious.
Nice cooker. Yeah.
The kitchen is lovely. It really, really is. Well thought out as well. Good use of space. Really nice and light.
Yeah, I love that framework bit around the range.
Yeah.
And it'd be an easier space to have to share with other people.
Especially because you've also got this.
Ah, look at this.
A whole nother reception room.
I did not expect this at all. This is a really nice surprise.
But I say, this is a bigger property because upstairs you have three bedrooms.
Hey, there we go.
Now I'm going to let you explore upstairs on your own. So you go and have a root around upstairs and then come back down and find me and we're going to go.
Wonderful. Thank you.
I see. I think that the space may be starting to dislodge the beauty of the first property and what they think of upstairs.
The upper floor has two double bedrooms, a single bedroom, a bathroom and additional WC.
Wow. The rooms are really decent size.
Yeah. There's a light coming in. The view is very nice. It's nice and nicely decorated.
Look how much wardrobe space they have. Yeah, it's really nice, really light.
Oh, this is lovely.
I really like this room, actually. I love that little alcove space. It's unusual, isn't it?
Desk area.
Yeah, it would be a really good desk area. Yeah, it's a lovely room. This is a really decent sized. And what I really like is we have a bath here too.
Did you get lost in the massive expanse?
Well, we did. We did.
It is spacious, though.
It's great, isn't it?
Three really nice bedrooms.
Now, you know that you wanted a hot tub.
Yes.
And a cowboy bar.
Yes. Yes. What are you going to show us?
We don't have them, but there's space.
There certainly is space. Outside, the quarter of an acre plot packs in a summer house, a choice of seating areas, mature trees and shrubs, and some additional outbuildings to the rear.
I think this would be a great space for a hot tub because there's electricity in here. Uh-huh. And then you've got the greenhouse. You've got this area for cocktails at sundown. Then a little place for lunch midway down the garden. And down by the house, a breakfast courtyard.
Morning coffee.
Yeah. The whole garden is very, very private.
Yeah, it's really unexpected.
It's a great garden.
How much do you think this one costs?
I'm going to say 305.
305.
Mm. So I'd guess about 310.
Oh, this is actually on the market for £325,000, but the owners are open to negotiation.
Okay, that's so reassuring.
Sorry to show you another one over budget.
That's all right.
Don't worry.
It was a good inn, and we wanted to show it to you. So why don't you kind of explore the garden, certainly, and inside again, because this is a bit bigger, this one, and then we will catch you at the front.
Great.
Okay. See you later.
See you.
The asking price of this former miner's cottage may be pushing the budget again, but they would get a lot of house here. There's a large kitchen, three further reception spaces, three bedrooms, and a garden with a selection of outbuildings. What's more, it's in a village location that's less than an hour from their jobs in Bristol.
The house itself is lovely, like it stands out from its neighbours because it's so well presented.
Space is really nice, it's really light. I like the little extra sitting room. The kitchen's big. Love the two cookers.
But my heart just didn't lift like it did when we saw the first property.
If I'm honest, I don't see it as our next house.
Okay, so that's our houses for the day done.
Okay,
well, thank you very much.
Let's go and have a little catch up.
Sounds good.
In the wonderful Wye Valley, helping Ruth and Marguerite from the City of Bristol to buy a house together for the first time with a budget of £300,000. I've already shown them two great houses and they seem to have lost their hearts to one, but there is still the mystery house to come, which could lead our search down the garden path.
Well, it goes down quite a way, so let's have a look.
Gosh.
And I head to the river to deal with a rather slippery fish.
I didn't think I'd ever cry over a released eel, but swim, my darling. Go on. Well, we all woke up this morning in the Wye Valley with little doubt about which house was Marguerite and Ruth's favourite from yesterday. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if they'd spent the entire evening trying to find the money they need to put an offer in on it. However, the mystery house is pretty unique for two reasons, actually. One, because of its layout, and also because of its location. All will be revealed. We were wondering whether you were on the phone to your mortgage advisors last night trying to find some more leverage.
Well, we think we can manage the extra. We think, like, well, not like for 330, but, like, you know, we're thinking, say, if we put an offer in for 315, and we thought, maybe our Chalmers first-time buyers.
Yes, it's a definite sort of golden bonus.
I really totally love the house. I'd totally live there. And I think anything else for me is going to be a bit of a compromise, and I really, really do not like compromising.
What do you think about the mystery house? What do you think we might show you for the mystery house?
Oh, that's a good question.
I think the compromise with the mystery house might be the garden, in some way.
No garden.
Yeah, no garden at all.
Yeah, I'm hoping that the mystery house is absolutely perfect and it
takes all the worries away.
Yeah, that would be my dream result for today.
Well, the twist in the tale for today's mystery house is that it's not a million miles away from that first property which still has such a hold over Marguerite and Ruth. We're back in Clandogo, whose Wye Valley charms are such that tourists and locals alike are drawn to it time and time again.
Come all the way from Deal in Kent, which is about 200 miles away, simply because we enjoy the wildlife and walking the dog. I recommend anybody to visit from all walks of life. It's all year round. Fantastic.
I grew up round here from the age of about 7. We love the area because of the community spirit there, especially. A lot of local people that have been here for generations, but also a lot of new incomers that have melded in with the locals very well.
I lived in a town for many, many years, and it was just really nice to get back to the countryside again, to the trees, the birds, the wildlife, and just the quietness. Perfect. Love it.
With such serenity on offer, it's easy to see why people return here. And we're no exception, because the Mystery House is in a very familiar location.
Does it ring any bells?
Yes, it does.
Oh, we're back.
We are back.
Now, this is a first on the show. I don't think this has ever happened.
Wow.
We came to see that house, which
we did. Yeah.
And the Mystery House is this one.
Oh, my God.
Okay. Come close, come close. What do you think?
Sounds good already, Alistair, yeah.
I think...
Do you think it could be...
I don't
be...
want to jump the gun, but I think you could make this really work.
Oh, gosh. All right.
Let's go.
Okay.
This mid-20th century mystery house is built into its hillside gardens, giving breathtaking views of the Wye. The central entrance takes us straight into the top floor.
Come on in.
Thank you.
Where we start our tour in the kitchen.
Look at this.
This is incredible.
Hello.
Wow. Washing up takes on a whole new meaning,
doesn't
isn't it?
It
absolutely
does. Fighting over it.
Yeah, I was about to say the same thing. I don't think you would ever tire of looking out the window and seeing that view.
Yeah. I really like this.
This is a really, really fantastic first impression. Like, I did not expect this.
It's a bombshell, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's like, bam! Wow.
Yeah. Seriously, look at the view.
Yeah. There is only one reception room here, but again, it's got great views. Ta-da! It's another lovely...
This is a really nice space.
Isn't it great?
Yeah,
come on in.
It's really
and space
good.
For dining table in the front room.
Yeah. Lovely modern log
burner. Yeah, absolutely. This is a lovely room, a really
and
lovely room.
I like the alcove.
Love the floors as well.
Yeah, really nice wooden floors.
Good, actually. Yeah. I really like it. It's cosy, but, you know, it's not too small.
Not at all.
Good, so thumbs up for the upstairs,
definitely,
downstairs.
Absolutely. Thumbs up.
Well, let's have a look at the bedrooms.
Okay.
Completing this first floor is a luxurious bathroom which serves two bedrooms, both located downstairs on the ground floor. A guest double has built-in wardrobes and a picture-perfect view to make the most of breakfast in bed. And next to this is a larger double that might suit the ladies of the house.
Oh, this
really
is a
really
nice
room.
Nice and bright, huh?
Yeah.
Love it.
And it's not like you stint on the view, you still get an amazing view.
Not at all, you're not overlooked.
If you peek that way, you get a nice view across to the other side of the village.
Oh, God, yeah.
And the garden, I love the garden.
This is incredible. It's a really nice feel. Imagine waking up and looking out there.
And your guests would be so happy.
Oh, yeah.
No, we wouldn't be able to get rid of them.
Yeah.
I feel really excited.
Mm-hmm. You like it? I can
I
see
do,
you
I
like
really
it.
Do like it. We really could put our stamp in this one house, but I feel we would have a bit more scope here to really make it our own.
For sure. Even more so in the garden.
Oh.
Which you can just access through this handy door.
Well, that is very handy.
Kaboom!
This is the largest plot I've shown them and surrounds the house on all sides. There are mature trees and wild areas, but I'm wondering if these novice gardeners will be inspired or slightly intimidated.
Wow.
Look at that.
Oh my God.
I'm just imagining coming out first thing. I'd sit on that step, drink my coffee.
Well, it goes down quite a way, so let's have a look.
Gosh.
The garden path leads to a line of trees at the bottom where there's a walkway all the way to the heart of the village.
So you can stroll back from the village.
It's really handy.
Pint of milk.
Yeah, indeed. Yeah. It would be a bit more of a project. I feel here we could spend plenty of time outside just having a good potter and giving it a go. And like things like that make us really happy.
Yeah, pottering, our favourite activity.
Absolutely.
Yeah, this is a really nice, attractive house.
So, the big question.
Oh, okay.
Can you afford it?
Well, this is the part that I'm worried I'm going to be crushed at. I'm going to say 310,000.
I'll go 315.
Well, I'm afraid you're both wrong again.
Okay.
Oh. This house is on the market for £295,000.
No way!
Yay!
We won it!
Yeah!
No way!
Oh my God, I did not expect you to say that. That is incredible. It just feels incredible that somewhere this beautiful, in such a gorgeous setting, is actually within our budget.
Why don't you go back inside and explore?
Yes.
And I will sun myself in your garden.
Yeah, that sounds good. You might not be able to get us out of here. Thank you.
No worries.
295.
Oh, it was worth it. All that torture and convoluted business, and it all paid off. Marvellous.
Sitting £5,000 below budget, this mid-20th century upside-down house has a large kitchen, a further reception room, two double bedrooms, and an expansive garden offering great potential. Plus, it's in a very peaceful location with those wonderful valley views.
Just an incredible first impression and an incredible, really good, positive feeling when we entered the property.
The kitchen is just like so bright, it's got to be one of the best washing up views ever. I feel no need to see any other houses. I kind of have been blown away by it in a funny sort of way.
Is that a phone box or am I just seeing things?
No, it is a phone box. Not another case.
It's usually the other way around. I'm waiting and you come out first time you're in the garden. Lovely.
Yes.
You enjoying your view?
Yeah, it's unreal. You can actually see 4 miles.
You can actually see 4 miles. But I'm going to have to tear you away, I'm afraid.
Okay.
It's not just our house hunters making the move to the Wye Valley. Others that come to this river have made a truly astounding journey. I've come to the riverbank to meet Richard Cook from the Severn and Wye Smokery to learn about the incredible secret life of eels.
Richard,
hi,
good morning.
Good to meet you.
Very lovely spot you've got here.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
And these are the chaps that we've come to investigate.
These are my babies.
Your babies, got quite a lot of them. Now, I remember very vaguely from school that eels have some crazy life cycle.
These fish are already 2 years old, so...
These are 2 years old?
Yeah, they've...
They're tiny.
They've travelled over from the Sargasso. They've come across on the North Atlantic Drift. They've drifted over
to... So how far is that journey?
About 6,000 kilometres. Yeah.
When they were super tiny then?
Yeah, yeah. So they started off as almost leaf-shaped, yeah. But they just float. And then they develop as they come over into what we call the glass eel, which is like a thread of glass with two little black eyes and a set of gills and a little heart that sits behind it.
So even tinier than this?
Yeah, 0.3 of a gram when they arrive.
The European eel is critically endangered. Organisations like the Sustainable Eel Group work with fishermen, scientists and conservationists to encourage responsible eel sourcing and restocking. These partnerships also help tackle illegal trade in the fish, a major threat to healthy populations.
70% of what we catch is released for restocking.
Where do you release them?
These are sold to primarily restocking projects across Europe.
So 70% of the glass eels go to European markets?
Yeah.
To restock their rivers?
To restock European waters. Restocking glass eels is a viable option.
But these eels are not off on a continental venture. They're heading back into the waters of the Wye.
OK, so can we free these chaps?
That's what it's about today, yeah.
I have to say, I now have a total respect for these chaps.
It feels really good when you let them go.
I know, yeah. And just literally tip them out here?
Yeah, just get them close to the water. Just let them slowly work their way out.
Ah! Swim, my darlings. Look at that, they're so happy. Oh, it's really, it was quite moving.
It is.
I didn't think I'd ever cry over a released eel, but... Oh, go on! Oh!
Well, that's the conservation bit.
Now perhaps we ought to consider the other 30% and see the results of aquaculture.
Scientists still don't know for certain where wild adult eels end their days. For some of Richard's eels, it's a different story. Once known as the fish of the poor, smoked eel... delicacy across Europe and beyond, and costs much more than smoked salmon.
It's really fatty, more meaty than like salmon. Very smoky, obviously, because it's been smoked, but quite chewy. Amazing. I did not know there was so much in an eel.
I must say it's been interesting and surprisingly tasty chewing over the life of the enigmatic eel.
Ah, oh, there they are. Pretty as a picture, having their tea. Let's find out which of the houses they're going to buy. I've so enjoyed showing you two round the Wye Valley.
Thank you, Alistair. It's been a great experience.
So which one is the contender?
Well, dun, go on, dun, Ruth. Dun.
Well, we're both totally gunning for the mystery house.
Yay. I think when you see a house like that, like they don't come along every day. Just could not believe when we rocked up and opened that door and there it was. Mm.
So what happens next? Ruth, right. You're the more practical one.
Okay, so... Well, we're definitely going to put an offer in.
Yeah?
Yeah, absolutely.
Definitely putting an offer in.
Yes.
Just go from there.
Great.
Mm-hmm. Well, I was hoping we'd be in this position at the end of this, but, you know, part of me was thinking, would it really happen? And I just cannot believe that, like, here we are.
That is like music to my ears. Well, let's hope that the offer is accepted, that you move in soon, you invite us back, we come to visit you.
To see.
let